and out of nowhere, I get this overwhelming urge. And this urge was, I needed to see a mass. I was afraid people would look at me. I was afraid that people would know immediately that I didn't belong in that church. You know, because you have to remember, during this time, the propaganda mill, you know, is like, it teaches us in the gay community that Christians don't like us. You know what I mean? It teaches us that we're like completely disgusting to them. And I get a lot of those messages, but just by being in the community, just by hearing other people, not from Christians themselves, but just by hearing it constantly.
Well, I end up going into the chapel, and it's packed.
And so I finally found this one little seat. It's by the, it's in the very back, and I'm facing everybody and nobody's behind me, which I really liked. It's taking everything in my body to stay in my seat because I'm so afraid. And there's this light. It's a candle. It's a red candle. It's hanging above all of them in the front. It is so calming to me. And all I could keep hearing in my head was, keep looking at me. Keep looking at me. And I stare at this candle. And then all of a sudden, the organ starts playing. And in that moment, as I'm staring at this candle, something changed me in that moment. I don't know what happened. Something came into my heart and I just fell apart. So I was trying to be this invisible creature in the back. And all of a sudden, I am weeping like a child because I've never felt more love in my entire life than that exact moment. It was like something just came in and took down the walls and broke the shackles of everything I thought I knew. And it was the most powerful moment of my life. I mean, it changed me forever. It was the moment that it was so clear that God was real, that he was showing me that I'm real, I'm here.